model should Nigeria be exploring that is sustainable for funding infrastructure development in the country?
Unless the government works actively with the private sector and getting them to participate, not necessarily only in the construction, but also in the financing, this is one route that will help to alleviate pressure on the public purse and addressing issues to do with the budgetary constraints.
How do you look at this whole idea about trying tested models for infrastructure funding?
The truth is that the public purse is never going to be enough. It's proven in our own case. And if you see the distribution of road network in Nigeria, the federal government own road is actually less than 20%. Federal government and state. The bulk is local government and state. And if road is to energize trade, enhances mobility, reduces costs to commuters and freight operators, it is a very important ingredient for growth. So we need to ask ourselves, if one model isn't working well, it's leading to loss of job. The other model can not only reduce costs, it can help you bridge the gap. Now, if the question is the length of time it takes to make a good bankable road, then we need to break down those elements that elongate the time.
How does the National Assembly take leadership in understanding the dire situation that we are in and helping to forge a national consensus behind PPP as a model?
For me and for the House, our understanding is annual appropriation should actually be interventionist. It should be an intervention to the fund that should be available for reconstruction. And that is why we initiated the Road Fund Bill, which has passed first reading, second reading, we've had public hearing, we elected to use technical team that will analyze the various issues. And I'm happy to let you know that that has passed top reading. So what does it bring to the process? It brings the process the avenue and opportunity to raise alternative funding for roads. Through road user charges, whether it's levy on petroleum, whether it is levy on wind bridges, whether it is tolling, there must be a body that is responsible for this. I believe that we should all collectively focus on helping have structures that will let us have alternative funding. Thank you very much.
Is there an advantage for you, and indeed for our people, for Nigerians, when a project is started with guaranteed funding in terms of efficiency and every other thing?
Of course, if there is a concept, if a project starts and the funding is guaranteed, it's not only for the MD that easier, because then I don't have I don't have to have sleepless nights because of debts, so I can concentrate on the work. So yes, there's a big difference.
What has been your challenge, and where are you in terms of just understanding and adopting the PPP model for road development?
With PPP particularly, this is something that honestly we're very skeptical about, it because we've had so many experiences in the past with PPP projects, like issues of litigation. What we are trying to identify now is to tighten all the bottlenecks. Because we don't want a situation where somebody comes, we reach into an agreement with him, he starts a project, eventually he comes up with fictitious claims. So I'm sorry about that. he comes up with something that maybe would be very challenging to the government. So we're looking into that, because the problem with PPP projects now is the issue of funding.
What kind of savings can be possible?
Now, a guaranteed money for project saves you time, saves you energy, even make it more predictable for investors and businesses around that place, that if I'm going to bear some brunt, it's just for 18 months, because the road here will be fixed. But where it is budgetary releases that is unguaranteed, that 18 months can be 18 years. Any day, anywhere, and any contractor will tell you, if I have a clear source of funding that you're going to pay me with, I can even discount my bill, because I will get out of your project in record time and I'm going to do other things. Now, that is why we are all craving for a better alternative to public finances for infrastructure.